So today we're going to learn how to make your R file or Jupyter notebook into an interactive session so that if you want to share with your students or teach them how to run the code without them to install all the necessary files, then you can make this happen using the help of the binder. So if you have a Jupyter notebook, then you can directly use the
website
to do it, or there's another way. You can first, you have to make an account on GitHub, then go to this repository and use this as a template, or you can fork it. Then let me create a repository. Then you will see, because we copied it from the main binder examples, you can see that it consists of three ways. You can make your RShiny app into this, or you can make an RStudio file or Jupyter with an R. So here you have to first upload your R file. So we will add R file to it. I'm using a file which I used before in my previous video, where I used LD. So I'll upload that. Come to changes. Here, then you can see that our file has been uploaded. Now we have to see the library's name. We'll copy it from here and go back. We will go to the install.r and change the install packages name. So here we have these libraries, so we have to install them. So I'll just cut and paste it over here. And then you will see that your installer is ready. Then we'll go back, and in the runtime, you have to write the latest version of your R, which you used to run this program. So just to check the version of your R, just type version in your console, and this is my version. So I'll just copy here and paste it in my runtime.txt file in this format. And then I'll just update the runtime and commit the changes. And in the readme, we'll make some changes also, which is related to R work. So it shows how to perform anything R. And over here, use your own username instead of binder dot dash example, that mine is mantra dash number. You will use your own GitHub username, and then instead of R, you will use the name of your repository. It will start building and it will take 3 minutes to run. So once it's done, I'll let you know how
it is. So once the binder will stop running, it will open RStudio in a cloud environment and with your specific R version. And here, then you can run your R file. Even you can upload your own data set. So I haven't uploaded the data for this R code, but when you make the binder for your own R code, you can upload the data also. And if your students or other people can test out your code in this iCloud environment, and also export the whole package from here to their desktop. So hope you like this video. Thank you for watching.